So this is part 2 of coordinate geometry past paper solving video. The second question says a straight line passes through the points 1, 2 and 5, -14. We have to find the coordinates of the midpoint. For a midpoint, we know that x1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2 is used. So our midpoint will be 1 plus 5 over 2, two plus minus 14 over 2. This will be 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 over 2 is 3, two minus 14 is minus 12 over 2 is minus 6. So the midpoint is 3, minus 6. Next part of the question says you have to calculate the gradient. My gradient is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So my y2 is minus 14, y1 is 2, and my x2 is 5 and x1 is minus 1. Therefore this will be minus 16 divided by 4, and minus 16 over 4 is minus 4. Moving on to the next part, the next part says you have to find the equation of PQ. For equation of any line, you either need two points or you need one point and gradient. In part B, we did calculate the gradient. Therefore, if we have one of the points, either P or Q, and the gradient, we can calculate the equation of the line. As discussed in class, to find the equation of a line, when we are given one gradient and one point, we use y minus y1 is equals to m x minus x1. y1 and x1 can be any of the points of P or Q. Let's say I use P, which is 1, 2. Therefore, this will be y minus 2 is equals to m. M is gradient, which is minus 4, bracket x minus x1. x1 will be 1 since I used 1, 2. Then it will become y minus 2 is equals to minus 4x minus minus plus 4, and I can write it as y is equals to minus 4x plus 6. Moving on to question number 12, which is from your June 2009 CIE exam papers. It says there are two points P and Q, 4, 7 and 8, -3, and you have to find the midpoint. Again, my midpoint formula is x1 plus x2 over 2, y1 plus y2 over 2. So over here my midpoint will be 4 plus 8 over 2, 7 minus 3 over 2. 4 plus 8 is 12, 12 over 2 is 6, 7 minus 3 is 4, 4 over 2 is 2. So my midpoint will be 6, 2. The next part of the question says find the length of PQ. For length, it is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Therefore, my x2 is 8 minus 4 whole square plus minus 3 minus 7 whole square. And if I solve it, this will be 8 minus 4 is 4 square plus minus 3 and minus 7 is minus 10, minus 10 square. This will be 4 square is 16 and 10 square is 100, 116 is 116. And since it is a paper 2 question, you can use your calculators and compute the value. It will be under root of 116, and under root of 116 is 10.77. or 10.77. 7 if you are supposed to write your answers to 1 decimal place. The next question says find the coordinates of the point where the line 2y is equals to 3x plus 15 crosses the y-axis. Okay, so at y-axis you should remember, as already discussed in class, that x is equals to 0. So if you have to find the coordinates of a line which is intersecting the y-axis, or the coordinates of the point where a particular line crosses the x-axis, you must remember that the coordinates of that point will have the x coordinate at 0, always x coordinate will be 0. For y coordinate, you can substitute the value of x as 0, and therefore your y coordinate will be 2y is equals to 3 into 0 plus 15, which will be 2y is equals to 15, and y will be 15 over 2, which is 7.5. So my coordinate will be 0, 7.5. Another way to solve this question is to bring your equation into a form which is y is equals to mx plus c, and have this c red. The c is your y intercept, and this will obviously be equal to 7.5 as well. Okay, so I will move on to the next part. The next part of the question says, well, this question is from your November 2009 paper 1. The coordinates of the point P and Q are given, and they are minus 1, 10, and Q is 3, 4. You have to find the gradient. Now for gradient, or M, M is equals to Y2 minus Y1 divided by X2 minus X1. So my M will be 4 minus 10 divided by 3 minus minus 1. 4 minus 10 is minus 6, and 3 minus minus 1, minus minus plus, so it will be 4. And if I cancel them, it will be 2 2's are 4 and 2 3's are 6, therefore minus 3 over 2, or I can say minus 1.5. So my gradient is minus 1.5. And the final part says find the midpoint. For a midpoint x1 plus x2 divided by 2, comma y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Therefore my midpoint will be, I will add the both the x values and take out the average, x1 plus x2 over 2 and y1 plus y2 over 2, and therefore if I have to find the midpoint, it will be minus 1 plus 3 over 2, comma 10 plus 4 over 2. Minus 1 plus 3 is 2, 2 over 2 is 1, and 10 plus 4 is 14, 14 over 2 is 7. So my midpoint is 1, 7. In next question, we are supposed to calculate the coordinates of the midpoint again. Question number 14, this pertains to your June 2010 paper 1 question. Let's solve the first part. It says that a straight line passes through the two points, and you are given two points. One is P, P is minus 8, 10, and Q is 4, 1, and you are supposed to calculate the midpoint. For midpoint, x1 plus x2 over 2, x1 is minus 8 plus x2, which is 4 over 2, and y1 plus y2, which is 10 plus 1 over 2. Minus 8 plus 4 is minus 4, minus 4 over 2 is minus 2, and 10 plus 1 is 11, 11 over 2 is 5.5. So my midpoint is minus 2, 5.5. In next video, we will solve more questions starting from June 2010, part B, and moving on. Thank you for watching this video.